Royce McGee, current active shop manager for the Cup side and Xfinity side. And I've been here since November of 97, which is quite a while, 22 years of it. So that's been quite the time. Had a couple of different roles at the organization and had a lot of opportunities to learn different values of the company too in this role. So. My role could consist of scheduling wraps for what paint scheme goes on the car, whether it's an Xfinity car or a Cup car, what cars go when we get stuff up and down the road on transporters, when the transporters leave, far as what cars, getting cars back and forth to NASCAR from that standpoint, scheduling that, working with the buying, getting approval on parts and pieces from that standpoint, making sure we're not overspending money, managing our inventory. Personnel, working with personnel, making who's, you know, working with Sammy, like if we need somebody extra to go to the racetrack, going and finding that guy, making, working through there, just a wide variety of things I do daily here.
You know, Royce McGee, he's as dedicated to this company. He'll be here Sundays. He's here 7 days a week if he needs to be. I've seen him here late at night working. He wants to make sure that everything, when those cars roll out to be put on the trailer, that he wants to make sure they're 100%. And that's how dedicated Royce is. He's been here quite a few years. I'm not sure how many now, but quite a long time.
I actually had an opportunity. I worked for Roush for a couple of years in their sports car field, went cup racing with them, went to work for Butch Mox Motorsports, Rick Masters driving the car. Kevin Hamlin, crew chief on the 31 car. We were beside each other a lot in the garage and had opening in his car chief role. So he convinced me to, didn't take a lot of convincing, but had the opportunity to come to work here and met with Richard and Kevin and worked out a plan for me to come to work and started in November of 97 as a car chief. Stability is the first thing. You know the company's gonna be here. That was one thing that when you're racing before and not knowing the race teams would always come and go or a lot of people don't realize the sponsors changed back then. The sponsor would leave, the whole race team left a lot of times. So you had stability coming, but it's an iconic organization that you got an opportunity to come and work for. You didn't get to go to work. I didn't get to work with Dale Earnhardt much. I got to go to a lot of tests with him, but just being associated with him and just being in the organization was great. I mean, especially when you make that phone call to your dad and he's telling where you're going to go to work at. It was pretty cool. It was two race teams. Is what it was. It was the three team at the top of the hill, and the 31 was in a new building at the bottom of the cul-de-sac. And we were just, you know, for RCR to have two teams was still really growing. It was going into its second year. So it was two independent race teams under one banner, is what it was. It was operated completely different. It had, you didn't share cars or inventory like we do now. So we did share notes and we did communicate, but it was definitely two fundamentally race teams at an organization. If you found something that worked better for your driver in your car, that's what you went and got. You didn't have to get it passed off through engineering, and it didn't come from you didn't have the engineering background that we have now. We didn't share parts back and forth between organizations. We would on Sunday on tires, because you could swap tires between teams, and that was about the biggest sharing we did. Occasionally we would loan a gear or transmission back and forth, but we had our own gear and transmission guy in one shop and own gear and transmission guy in another. Cars didn't go back and forth as much as they do now. Now, if you look at the way we operate as a fundamental company, trying to do more with less like any other company, we've got a smaller amount of inventory. We rotate that inventory between, it doesn't matter where that goes on a car. We keep track of where it raced at and the mileage of it, but we put them parts where they're needed the most, and we don't say those are mine and these are yours. It's ours, and we use them across the board where they need to go next. Yeah, well, it started out as a car chief here on that 31 car, and RC's very active in what goes on at the racetrack. He'll come up and ask you what's going on, what are you doing, what have you changed, and he's always wanting to know what you're doing. From that standpoint, it was really cool to see him being that involved as an owner and understand what your car's wanting. And then it got an opportunity to be a crew chief. And now he's asking you why you did that in your car and getting on to you or discussing how to make changes with your car to make it better. And from the owner's standpoint, is he might see something you don't. And now he comes in here and asks me, hey, where's this car going? Because of my role here now, it's he's wanting to know where the inventory is, what we're doing, why are we keeping this car, what are we doing with that car, It's pretty interesting. He's definitely engaged with what goes on around here. Well, first thing, we didn't have as many cars. We had like 7 cars we rotated around between short track and intermediate cars, and you always had 2 speedway cars. Now we got like 12 cars we rotate around, but we don't have enough parts to build all 12 at one time. So it's kind of a, when you say I got 12 cars, we got 12 chassis and bodies we rotate because we have to work on them so much. We did start with a chalkboard, and then it went to a dry erase board, and it had dates on the encounters. Then we moved into the age of trying to use a digital calendar, and that works really good now with Excel spreadsheets, and we have it on a mutual website here that we use as SharePoint, and anybody that we can give access to that calendar can view it anywhere. You can log in. You can be sitting in Texas last week, and crew chief can be looking at the same document I'm looking at, talking about, hey, I don't like that car going there. Can we take this car? So it's a the digital age has definitely helped us on scheduling and tracking things greatly. Richard has a knack for seeing things coming and making changes to the organization to stay one with the technology. He's got people in place to make sure we have the technology we need to make things happen. How to manage our budgets better so we don't put ourselves over and out too bad. He has that knack for seeing that, and he makes everybody understand how we need to keep our company intact. Gets on us when we don't perform. So we've had ups and downs. I think we're on the verge of winning a couple races here in a row. We've got good speed in our cars this year, but definitely longevity and is definitely the thing about this place here in the 50 years. Long time ago, he asked me a couple of questions. I answered, and he goes, "Well, that's pretty brutal." I said, "Well, don't ask if you don't want to be honest. I mean, I'm going to be honest with you. I mean, no." So a long time ago, back in 97, where actually it was Vegas race, we were sitting there on 98, first Vegas race we were there. He asked me, we were starting terrible. We were qualified bad, and we were standing there, and he goes, "It's a long way to that 3 car from here, son." I said, "Yes, it is." I said, "Bad thing, it probably won't get no better today either." And he's like, "Surely." I said, "That's the way it is." I said, "We're struggling here." I said, "We'll be lucky if we get out here with a decent finish." So he got on to me about, he said, "Man, that's kind of brutal." I said, "Well, that's the facts. I mean, that's what it's going to be." And ever since then, he knows I'm going to give him a straight up answer, and he might not like the answer, but he's going to get the straight up answer.
Well, Royce is a leader. Number one, you got to have a leader to have everyone else that's involved in the cars, from the chassis to the rear end department to the setup plates, body shop. You have to have, everybody has to have confidence in your leader. And that's the greatest thing about Royce McGee. He's a great leader, and people really love working with him.
Well, I had an opportunity. We're gonna do crew chief change on the 31 car at the end of 2001 with Gil Martin. Richard asked me, he had some things, once again, Richard looking ahead in the world and in our organization. He gave me an opportunity, said, "Hey, we're gonna do something a little different. I need you to stick around for me." And I was a young guy, and I was trying to figure out what I wanted to do next. I still wanted to be involved with racing and being part of the car. And he had to enlighten me on what his plan was so I would stick around, and gave me the opportunity to help be a shop foreman when we had 3 cars at the time. It was the 29, the 31, and the 30 it came with Jeff Green. Told me what he wanted. The crew chiefs wanted a guy on the shop that could constantly keep things going, and we wouldn't skip steps just to get a car done and help that. And learning how to delegate was a huge thing. Can't do it all yourself. You gotta have good people around you. Like we do now, we still got good people, and just learning how to be a good manager. I explained to my wife, she goes, "Why do you want to do this instead of being a crew chief or a car chief anymore?" I said, "Well, one day I got to get a real job," and I said, "At least it'll look good on the resume if we're going to work at Walmart." So.